Riley, a tough match. Can you just talk about what it felt like to make your Laver Cup debut and the match today against Casper?
Casper, I thought, was great. He came out firing, and I thought his level was extremely high throughout the entire match. And I was just kind of hanging on, trying to survive and possibly turn things around. I didn't play the break points so well. And, I think that was the biggest difference maker in the end. But Casper was on it. He was a better player.
Patrick, your thoughts on today's first match?
Yeah, I think Casper was extremely consistent, took advantage of his, couple opportunities he had. Riley was able to get himself a couple of chances in the second set. And obviously, if he had converted one or two of those, we'd be in a super tiebreak. So I was happy with the effort was there. The intensity was there. And now we just got to get back out there and see if we can get one now.
Guys, we'll move online. Craig, we'll start with you, please. Please unmute yourself.
Just some technical issues here, but a question to Riley. Riley, a big moment for you to play this first rubber of the Laver Cup for this year. Just some of your thoughts as the match progressed. What were you thinking in an effort to try and get past Casper Ruud?
The conditions is the slowest condition I've ever played in. The combo with the court and the ball, so. I was just trying to make some adjustments, use the serve and volley, go a little bigger on the first serve, and look to be more aggressive. I thought I did a better job of that. I had some looks to break and just didn't crumble my way. But I thought I at least, gave myself a shot there for a guy that was playing on a condition that suits him better than me and playing extremely well. And he's top 10 in the world for a reason.
A reminder to those of you online, if you have a question, please use the raise your hand function. Diego, when you're ready.
Thank you. Hi, Riley. First of all, thank you for your press conference. Riley, do you think that maybe today one of the most difficult things was to return the Casper Ruud serve? He served quite well with a high percentage of first and second serve. That was a little bit complicated maybe for you today. Thank you.
No, I thought the biggest complication was just how many balls were coming back in play. I mean, I got broken twice in one set. That doesn't happen too often. If you watch me play, I'm not known to be winning a lot of these first serve and second serve return points. But I bet the stat line showed that I won a lot less first serve and second serve serving points, and I think that was more of a concern than the return.
Gentlemen, one more question. Craig, last question coming to you.
Ronnie, what was the experience like about having the guys come from the bench actually coming up to you, giving you advice in addition to John and Patrick and all that there? It's obviously something that you would not have experienced before.
Yeah, it's great. It's comforting for sure. At the end of the day, I've played 20 weeks this year. I know my game the best. I have the best feel for what's going on out there. But it is nice to have, Johnny Mac in your ear. I mean, it's just, one thing that is, you can tell what made Johnny Mac so great with his mindset. He's very optimistic. Things went south early and he was just very optimistic, like with how to turn things around. And he got me thinking right away for what I need to do to turn things around. And I almost did. It didn't, like I said, it didn't go my way, but that's the sport for you.
Frederick, you are live.
Yes, Riley, you also played Casper in Cincinnati not so long ago. Did you notice any difference? Differences in his game from then, or
completely different bigger court. Cincinnati was fast and live. This was slow and dead. Definitely the most extreme condition I've played in here in terms of speed of ball and court. Completely different.
Yakim, you are live.
Yes, Riley. You've met Casper a few times now in different conditions, as you say. What impressed you the most about the young Norwegian?
Today, everything.
Ivan, you are live. Please unmute. Thank you.
Yes. Hi, Reilly. What are your feelings about having a tennis legend like John McEnroe as captain?
It's great. You know, he's a, like you said it best, he's a legend. He's fun to be around. He's competitive as hell, which that's something I think we all share in the locker room. And he's, like I said, he's very realistic and he's optimistic. He's a straight shooter. He tells you like it is. When we're setting the lineup and we're doing things right, he's not, you know, kissing everyone's ass, telling us how great we are. He's shooting us straight, telling us like it is. That's how I like it. That's how we all like it. And, you know, he's a legend for a reason. It's great to spend time around a guy of mine like his and his brother right here. Two of the best tennis minds there are.
General, that concludes our press conference. Thank you for your time.
Thanks, everybody.